if I did that dumb thing where I started my videos with a random clip, I'd be like, we have a bus, it has wings, can it actually fly? Find out in this video. Hey, this is YBR with Beeman G Drive, and today we're going to be taking a look at a mod called the Danzler C1500, and this is a mod I made a video for in the past, but it had a completely different name, and it was just the regular factory standard edition. With this version, there's close to 20 different configurations that we can drive. So we're going to start with the factory standard, which is just an ordinary school bus, but it does have a lot of neat little features. For example, if we hit M, it opens up the doors, and then also it opens up the stop sign on the side. Then we could also hit K, which will open up the rear door as well, so you can get the children out of the bus when they're messing up your weight distribution. And then we also have V, which will open up the air brakes on the roof. Those are totally air brakes, guys. Trust me. So I also went to the perfect place to try to drive a bus. We're basically at the top of a mountain, and we're gonna drive down very, very badly. I'm not gonna try at all to stay on this road. We're gonna whip it around, and if we can't make the corner, well, tough luck. The bus is gonna fall off the edge, just like so. Also, you see that chair on the underside of the bus? Don't know what that's about. It's just a random chair that's there. It's for the ghost children, I guess. Just ignore it. It's a minor glitch that's gonna be there probably pretty often, I think. But anyways, let's go ahead and try to get this bus back onto its wheels and take a better look at the damage. There we go. Don't you dare try to roll away on me now. So nothing spectacular here, but there is a lot of damage overall to the bus after doing something dumb like jumping it off of a cliff. So let's get a new one and take a quick look at the interior. And one thing that's neat is there's just a lot of details in here. So we have all these extra caution signs over here telling you to watch your step as you fall out of the bus. Then we have all kinds of buttons over here. We got the mirrors on the side, just a ton of little things everywhere. As for the functionality here, we have a working steering wheel, working gauges, and then also working pedals down below. However, if you turn on the headlights, they do not do anything. They don't light up the gauges, nor do they light up the exterior area. So you're always driving in the dark with this guy. So probably best off to use him only during daytime. We also have a couple of alternative camera angles like this one here, which is at the very back of the bus, one that's right in the middle of the bus, and then also one that's right in the front of the bus. Anyways, I thought it was pretty nice falling off the cliff, so why don't we go ahead and do that again, but we'll fall in a different area. So if we go over here in the dirt, this is perfect area for a bus to drive, and goodbye, bus. What we actually gotta do is we gotta see, can we really round that corner if we try to take it properly with the bus? That will be a really good test to try out after he's done crashing. I like the way it just keeps rolling and rolling and rolling. So it ended on its side, but that's fine because that's a pretty good angle to take a look at the damage. And surprisingly, again, not that much damage for literally jumping off of a cliff. So to try to conquer this mountainous region, we need a bus specifically designed for that. And if you look at the Performance Tuned Edition, that's what it says. It was built for mountainous terrain. So with the Performance Tuned Edition, you actually basically have four of them that are almost identical. You have the driver plus two passengers, driver plus four passengers, and driver plus six passengers. And all that does is it takes the Performance Tuned and it adds some passengers to it. And I think going back and forth between the buses like this, and you just look at the big picture, and it's like the bus is dancing, isn't it? Just kind of amusing to me. Anyways, we're going to go with the driver plus six passenger variant. And this one has a pretty nice engine in it. It has almost 500 horsepower and almost 1500 foot-pounds of torque. That's like 200 horsepower more than the standard and like 500 foot-pounds of torque more. So the first try on this corner, I'm not going to use the e-brake at all. I'm just going to try to round the corner like a normal bus would. You slow it down, you take it extra wide because there's nobody else here, and you try to stay on the road on both the front and the rear. And that went pretty good. Yes, we went in the dirt some, but that was perfectly reasonable. So this bus is surprisingly nimble. Also, if we go to the inside, you can see my passengers. Hello, passengers. Are you guys also enjoying this bus ride? Oh, I love the way their hands just go up in the air like they're on a roller coaster, like, woo, as they're crashing off the side of a mountain. Oh, that was great. All right, so again, probably the bus doesn't look too bad. Yeah, a little bit worse than last time, surprisingly, but bus is strong. Something like that, barely gonna slow it down. Let's get it back onto the road, though. And what I want to try to do now is I want to see, can we drive hard enough to make all the dummies fall out of their chairs? But first off, look at this dude in his racing suit, looking like he one hand in the steering wheel, trying to look cool driving a bus. You're ridiculous, my man. He probably think he's so cool. And then all the kids just laugh at him. So here we go, whipping it hard. Do the dummies fall? Ah, they are very stable in their seats. Because I even saw the bus lift up a little bit into the air. So you're not going to get the dummies to fall out of their seats normally. But you get a lot more G's when you experience a crash than go around a corner. Oh, that was a lot. Those dudes are buckled in. You can see the seats have been completely shifted about, but they are in their seats still. And I feel bad for them now, actually, because that looks extraordinarily painful. And where did the driver go? He fell out of his seat. Hey, somebody fell out of their seat. All right, I'll take that as a win. All right, bring this guy back to where he were. And on to the next configuration of the bus. This one is the State Prison Edition. So this one has an engine right in between the regular one and the one we were just driving, but it also has a different paint job on it that is specifically made for transporting criminals. And once again, it also says West Coast on it. One thing that's cool about this one is if you look at the doors and the windows, they are reinforced so they can't break out of the bus. Although the door on the rear still looks like you could easily just open it up, which is a little bit suspicious, but they got metal bars over the windows at least. That's something, I guess. And going hard around that corner, it's surprising just how easily you can kind of get the inside of the bus to lift up when you do a real serious corner. At the same time, it's surprising how easy it is to slide it around the corners too. Easy slide onto the bridge, super clean. Wow, I just realized we are going like 70 plus miles per hour for a second there. And we're doing it again. We're almost gonna hit 80 miles per hour. And this ain't even a high performance version of the bus. This thing is hauling. Oh, we're topped out. We got no more gear left. All right, let it fly then. Let it fly. Nice air time. Ooh, good destruction too. Can we still drive? Look at this, landing on our wheels. Come on. Oh, it almost landed on the wheels. Just a little roll at the end there. Come on now, get up and fight. Whoop, there we go. Can you go? Oh yeah, just barely, because this thing looks messed up, but we can drive and it's gonna tip over, isn't it? I gotta stop steering so hard. Wow, it really is like leaning super hard though. This is weird looking. Anyways, that is the Prison Transport Edition. Even when we're doing nonsense like this, the prisoners cannot escape. We also have a stripped down configuration, which is the most boring version, but this is kind of interesting because of how slow it is. This thing only has 124 horsepower and 347 foot-pounds of torque for a whole bus. Now, it does have a stripped interior as well, so that helps lighten the load a little bit, but still, that's not a lot of engine for a bus this big. So we gotta see, how does it drive? So we're just gonna go ahead and teleport it onto the road, smack into the ground, that's fine. And let's try to get it going. All right. Yes, I broke the hood a little bit, that's okay. So driving it around, how slow is it? Well, we're flooring it right now, and I think we even have just a smidge of downhill going. And it definitely feels a lot slower than the prison transport, that's for sure. We got a lot of downhill going now, so we can get up to like 50 miles per hour, at least just for a second before we gotta slow down for the corner. And then here's the real test. We have a little bit of an uphill here, and we're gonna floor it. And with that uphill, we are actually losing speed. This bus is pathetic. They need a much bigger engine in it. Look at this pathetic itty-bitty engine. Oh, wouldn't it be cool if the hood just popped open because I slammed on the brakes so hard? That would have been neat. But instead, we can do that. Yep, there we go. And here is the pathetic engine we have, which is actually the same as the others, but it doesn't have a turbo installed. Because, for example, if we go out and get the next version we're going to drive, which is the off-road edition, and then we go ahead and take a look at the engine on this guy, you'll see, again, it has the same gravel block we saw. But most importantly, it has some turbos on it. Look at that. It actually is a twin turbo configuration. And those turbos are big and mean in this version, because this one has like 777 horsepower. And it's got a pretty big lift on it too. This thing has like a couple feet of ground clearance and 45 inch tires. All right, look at the way it's just trucking through Utah, USA with ease. Although we are a little bit stuck here, unfortunately. Oh, it made it. I thought we were stuck, but somehow it pulled through. Thank you, off-road bus, for being a beast. And I did just break off one of the exhausts, which I gotta mention. It does have exhausts that look completely absurd on a school bus. Like, the children are gonna burn their hands on that every single day. But it has a really cool exhaust, doesn't it? Oh, look at that. We can drive right through the water beautifully. I can be a submarine if I wanted to. Ha ha! Actually, wait a minute. Is the engine really above water? Yeah, it looks like just the top of it is above water. I'm just assuming the air intake would be at the top of the engine, so we're good to go. This thing's a pretty good off-roader, but just for fun, let's give it an easy task. I'm not going to do anything hard here. I'm just going to ask it to drive around on a dirt road, which it should be able to do very, very easily. In fact, I bet we could do this using just the standard bus if we wanted to, but overkill is nice every now and then, and this is definitely overkill, although look at it starting to tip over on me a little bit. Don't you tip. Stop it. Oh my goodness. I know it looks like we're only tipping a little bit. The thing is, this bus is pretty top heavy with the extra lift, and I'm just afraid to let it tip even just a little bit. So here we go. We're going to go straight across the water. Beautiful. Whoa. We got popped into the air there. It just got like suplexed onto our back, and we're like a turtle just completely stuck upside down. Anyways, I'm going to change maps real quickly, so we're going to head over to Derby Arenas. And we're going to drive the figure eight using a bus. So we're going to use the off-road four-wheel drive version. Yes, that's the exact same name as the previous one, but obviously this is different because just look at it. It has a completely different paint job, and also it's stripped down a little bit more, so it's missing pieces like the front bumper, the panels on the roof, all kinds of little things like that. And then also, it has nitrous, which yes, we will be using. So then we got to ask the question, is this a good idea? No, driving the bus around the figure eight is a very bad idea. That's why we're doing it. First jump was actually super clean, my goodness. And this corner, also surprisingly clean. We are bouncing around a lot, I'll admit that, but it's doing a swell job. I thought for sure we would flip over on like the very first corner or something. Okay, here's some danger though. Oh, but it will land it and it will keep going. We're gonna make the figure eight in a bus. I can't believe it. I thought for sure we would just get stuck almost immediately, but we are flying, literally flying. We're okay-ish. The rear suspension is blown out, but we are so close. We are gonna finish a lap, even if it completely destroys this bus. Come on, front wheel drive power. Just drag that rear end along. Let's go. Come on, we're almost there. Success. That is a full lap using a bus. That was truly amazing, especially when you look at the rear suspension. And yeah, I don't even know what's going on with that thing. The whole rear wheel's just completely shifted and it's sagging, but it made it. So the next version we're going to be taking a look at is the Derby Red, and this version is for derbying, obviously. So I'm going to go ahead and get us a little environment for this, and I'll be back once it's ready. Alright, here's the configuration. We got my bus over here with its perfect derby paint job, ready to do some derby racing. And then over there, we have the competition. And I'm gonna put the AI to chase me, so that means it's all of them versus me. Let's go! That was a really big impact. And I don't really know who won and who lost right now. It's just complete chaos, basically. We are definitely stuck together, which is a bit of a problem, but I think I got a solution. If we go through here just like this, we're going to rip them right off. There we go. And now I can actually drive a little bit, which means I can smush them out of the way. Ha ha! I am going to win this derby. Although the front of my bus doesn't look like it wants to. The whole front is completely falling off, but the engine's still attached. That's what's important. And I love that dude trying to hit me, and it did nothing at all. Absolutely nothing. Oh, this is gonna be good. Crush them into the wall. Oh, wow, I shot them out of the arena. That was good. But man, they just keep beating on me. Oh, come on, come on, bus. Come on, bus. Come on, bus. The problem is I just don't have enough power to drive with them shoving into me. So I just end up going really slow, but I'm not being stopped. That's the thing, I am nice and strong. See this car that's stuck on me? I'm gonna just rip them right off. Here we go. Bye! Oh, I kind of got stuck a little bit there, but that mostly worked. Except, they are really on me, aren't they? All right, can we back it up? Oh, I am stuck. I am done. I am eliminated from the derby. So that's pretty much it for the derby version, but one more final big collision with everybody coming at me at once, and that was beautiful. That truck, he just completely whiffed crashing into a bus. How do you manage that? So anyways, that's it for the derby version. It did a great job here, but the next ones I want to drive, why don't we actually go to West Coast USA since they all say West Coast on them? And now we're going to take a look at some of the more ridiculous versions of the bus. First off is the 6x6 Bulldozer, which is available with 6-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. So what's the difference between the two? One of them has lock differentials, one of them has locking differentials. That's really all that's important there. And just looking at this thing, it's a monster. It's got big old tires in the front and the rear. It's got quad exhaust, cinder blocks on the inside to weigh it down, and then the huge engine that sticks out of the hood. And of course, this guy, which is perfect for ramming through traffic probably, right? Well, let's go and spawn some traffic up and find out. And don't you love it how they place them right in front of you? Perfect for just straight ramming into. Seriously, I couldn't have placed them any better if I tried, as we just easily plow through all of these fools like they are nothing to me. Oh no! I was so busy looking at the traffic, I wasn't looking at where I was going. Oh man, but we caused so much destruction. That was great. Hey, where do you think you're going? You don't overtake me. Oh, that guy got so lucky I got distracted because I would have blown him up too. Seriously, this bus is great. It's just plowing through everything. It has so much power and so much weight. It's ridiculous. Although with great power and great weight comes really poor braking capabilities. Oh, look at that T-Series. We gotta smash him good. Oh, yes. Ha ha. I completely destroyed that T-Series. Although, yes, I also completely destroyed myself. But the T-Series got the worst of it, I think. So anyways, in addition to this version, we also have another one that's very, very similar. But this one has the plow on it. Although it's pretty much the exact same experience of, I am big, I am heavy, I am fast, you stay out of my way for your own good because you will get smashed to bits. I think this way is a little bit more durable because the vehicles deflect off a bit more and it doesn't absorb the impacts as much. But either way, we got tons of destruction going on at all times. Are they, oh no! Again, corners are not the easiest thing to do, but I did manage to make it around that time. And here's another T-Series. Wreck him. For some reason, I really want to wreck T-Series right now. Oh, wow. You can see the whole front of my vehicle is all tilted to the side. Although, there's an easy fix for that. Boom. It's as good as new and ready to plow. First plow, nice and easy. We go careful, and then we floor it, and we are going to plow into them at like 100 miles per hour. Here we go. 101, and yes. Oh, except I got a little bit stuck too, but that was pretty good. So let's try a little bit of a different strategy here. My normal strategy has just been floor it everywhere, but this time we're going to go nice and slow, so that way when we see a corner, we don't just crash into it. We can actually go around it. And now you can see just how powerful this thing is. Even at lower speeds, it is effortlessly bashing everybody out of its way. That COVID did not stand a chance. This van also does not stand a chance. Nobody does. T-Series, they stand a chance. But I'm still easily stronger. The 6x6 configuration is just absurd. Although, this guy is a little stuck under my wheels, I think, or something, so I can't steer very good. So I guess the old strategy of just flooring it is gonna come back. Oh, not yet though. Ooh. That was a hard hit. We hit the sidewalk with the ramp and somehow that damaged the exhaust. That was weird. But we can still drive, so let's just floor it and see what happens. And we're already at 100 miles per hour and we're already crashing as well. Whoa! Ha ha! Weird! That was a beautiful crash. So let's go ahead and take a look at the next configuration we're going to be driving. So this one is the Jado rear-wheel drive, and there's also a Jado Rocket version of the bus that already comes in the game, so we need to figure out which one is faster. So I'm gonna set up a drag race between the two, and I'll be back once it's ready. Okay, we are all set up, ready to race the AI, and one nice thing is when we use rockets, our overall speeds aren't that much different compared to regular cars. Ooh, they were off the line faster than me, but look at this! My rockets are better! So this one is far superior to the original one, and it's almost a whole second faster in the quarter mile. If I had a better launch, it probably would have been. And we can keep on going, and then we are gonna go for a flight at like 300 miles per hour. And look at how beautiful we're flying, even though this isn't the one that is made for flying, which we will be taking a look at very, very soon. But before we do that, we gotta let this kite come to a stop eventually so we can take a look at the damage. There we go. Well, the bus is flat. It's so flat, in fact, we are upside down, yet the rear wheels still found a way to touch the ground. Don't ask me how that works, but that is mighty impressive. One neat thing, though, is if we go back and do another drag race, there are a few other options that make sense here. So now we're going to go with one of the drag versions. So we have drag rear-wheel drive and drag ludicrous edition. So we're going to try both of those out and see which one's better. And again, for comparison purposes, what better to race against than the bus we just raced previously? And on paper, they should win, right? They have Jado rockets equipped. I am just all motor with my bus. Nothing fancy going on here. So here we go, trying to launch it nice and good, and I'm actually launching off the line faster than them. But how is the overall acceleration? I'm doing pretty good, and I am gonna get the victory. You will notice though, their trap speed was higher than me. If this was a little bit longer of a race, they probably would have won. Thankfully, it's only a quarter mile. Now, we're going to try the next configuration, which is the Drag Ludicrous Edition. And one thing that's funny about these buses is they both have wheelie bars on the rear, but I don't think they actually touch them at all because they just put the power down nice and cleanly. You see just a little squat and it goes. So it feels just as fast off the line as the other one, but then it just keeps going and going and going. And you can see it right there. The other one, they had a higher trap speed on me and they were gaining. Not this time. I am still accelerating hard. And look at this. We are at like 240 miles per hour before we hit the end here. And we were going only like 270 even with rockets attached to the bus. That is crazy fast. The only difference is we can't fly as fast because we can't accelerate in the air like we could with the rockets. One surprising thing though is not that much damage to the bus for driving it over 200 miles per hour. Anyways, time for another vehicle change. We're going to go with the Drift Edition. So we have it in rear-wheel drive or four-wheel drive versions. And I think the rear-wheel drive version is better, so we'll save the best for last. So the first thing we got to do, though, is get off of the drag strip. Because drifting on a drag strip, well, that's boring. Although, really, you can drift on straightaways with this thing. Look, we are drifting on a straightaway perfectly fine. The hard part is just fitting on the straightaway and drifting at the same time. So here's the first real corner, trying to get into it, and then we gotta really whip it around it. Oh! My engine just died mid-corner. Ha! Okay, that is definitely something you gotta watch out for, I guess. If you let the engine's RPM get too low, it's just gonna stall out on you. Let's see if it does it again. Yep, there we go. It was at no RPM, and I could put no power down. So what you gotta do is just, as you hit the e-brake, just keep putting the power down, and it'll be okay. So that's what we're going to do on these next two corners coming up. First one, going in tight, e-braking it, power. Oh, yes. And I know I'm a little bit off the course, but I did not want to hit the rear end. Because with it being so long, it's really easy for you to hit the rear end. And it's much easier just to try to control the front as tight as you can to the inside of the corner. And I don't know about you guys, though, but this is definitely the first time that I can remember ever having a bus designed for drifting that actually works really, really well. Then again, how many times have I tried to drift a bus ever? That truly is the next question you would ask. But anyways, I said earlier that the rear wheel drive version is better. So let's go ahead and crash this guy, and then we're gonna change to the rear wheel drive one, although I wanna make sure he's not stuck on the wall, and then we can go ahead and grab him. And really the biggest difference I notice is this one can drift at much lower speeds. And then also, that makes it feel a lot more nimble as it goes around the corners. So to try to demonstrate this, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the same spot where we stalled out earlier, but I'm gonna do a full 180 drift on this thing. So first we drift to the left, get a nice big wide opening, and then we whip it to the right as hard as we can, do the 180 maneuver. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at how tight it maneuvers. That was a thing of beauty. And I don't think we could do that as easily with the four-wheel drive one just because we have to break traction on four wheels. And when you're trying to do that, you end up going at much higher speeds. But this one, we're at nice low speeds that allows us to do a lot more wacky, ridiculous things like what I just did there. So one more drift before we finish this up. And again, just some really nice drifting by this vehicle, at least as nice as you can do with the bus. The nice thing is you can just barely tap the corners and it does absolutely nothing because there's so much overhang on the vehicle. Anyways, I think that should do it for the drift bus. So we're gonna go and just bash them into the wall, which is perfectly color matched to the bus. And now we're gonna take a look at the version everyone has been waiting for. The version that can fly. But to do that, I wanna do it properly. So we're gonna go to Italy, and then we're gonna go to the runway so we can take it off like a real plane. And this is a huge runway, so if this thing is gonna fly, it will fly here. But first, the pre-flight inspection. So it looks like an ordinary bus, but we got some wings strapped to the top here, and then also a rudder on the rear and some Jator rockets. We also have additional controls that'll allow us to control it in the air, but we can use them on land as well to do some weird things like dancing the bus from left to right, because why not? Or you could do the world's biggest stoppie using a bus. We stoppied so hard, we actually completely flipped over. Also, now would be a good time to mention, if I did that dumb thing where I started my videos with a random clip, I'd be like, we have a bus, it has wings, can it actually fly? Find out in this video. And the answer to that question is yes, it can in fact fly. It doesn't fly the greatest, but the fact that it does fly at all is absolutely amazing and it makes no sense, but I love it. So if my kids are gonna go to school, this is the bus I want them to take. The only question is how are they gonna land? It actually is a really good question. How do you land this thing? Because it's not really easy to land because we don't have that much control over it. Yes, I can influence the direction it goes, but I don't feel like I have a lot of precision like some of the other planes that I've flown in this game. So we can kind of do a loop and try to get back to the runway, but we are just way too high because I wasn't really planning on that. So instead, we're gonna go over the runway. I'm just gonna find a field to try to plant this thing down as gently as I can. And considering the fields aren't usually that flat, I expect this to go absolutely terribly. So there are all the fields. All I gotta do is pick one. Well, first off, we gotta get a lot lower. We are way too high, so I'm just letting it fall basically with no thrust at all, trying to scrub off some height. And there we go, we're getting low. Can we clear these trees though? Oh, this is close. Ooh, just barely. All right, keep going, scrub off the speed. Keep it level. Although I notice eventually you go so slow, keeping it level, everything just kind of goes weird. Just like that, now it's going sideways. I don't know exactly why. We're tipping back a ton, thrust it or something. Honestly, that was pretty good. Yes, we look a bit like a banana, but that was a surprisingly good landing for just landing in the middle of a field, I would say. So I think that's going to do it for Italy, and now we got to finish up with everybody's favorite, Leap of Death, and yes, they're going to do a couple of runs there. We'll do one with the guy who flies, and then one that doesn't fly. And we're going to start off with the regular version, although it's not really regular, because I'm going to use the Bulldozer 6x6 for this so we can get as much traction in the dirt as possible to go off the edge without using thrusters. And thankfully, we are not stuck in the wall, so we can immediately accelerate, going decently fast here off of the jump at about 70 or 80 miles per hour, I would think. And now for the long flight down. You can see the exhaust system here. So it is actually connected to those ridiculous pipes that stick upwards. That's pretty cool to see. And then now, how about the crash? Using maximum slow-mo, and I like you can see the windows just popping out one by one. Like boop, 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 boop. It's like bubble wrap. Although they are all popped now. How disappointing. Although now you can see it actually getting squished. The windows are becoming much, much smaller. I think we can go ahead and speed it up some. All right, looking good. Yep, all the way to right here for the next impact. And actually, you know what? Let's watch the front of the bus, not the bottom. There we go, a little shaky, it's okay. And then it keeps on flying. Oh, that's funny. So you know, I did mention earlier that it has cinder blocks strapped to the inside to make it heavier. Well, now you can see the cinder blocks just planted in the bus because they are indestructible apparently. So this bus is gonna make it all the way to the water surprisingly fast and surprisingly easily. So now let's go ahead and do the plane one, and I'm pretty sure that this one will get stuck here with the wings sticking out, won't it? Surprisingly it might be okay. Just gonna be very, very careful. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go as fast as I can, and once I hit the ramp, I'm just gonna let it fly, because we already know with enough thrust it can fly. So I want to see what happens if you throw it off a leap of death, kind of like a glider, and just let it glide to the bottom, all naturally like, because I'm not going to do any steering even. I'm just going to let it go and see what happens. And it's actually doing pretty well. In fact, it's even leveling itself out a little bit as it reaches a higher speed. Interesting. So it's going to completely overshoot the water, and it's going to go straight into another wall on the other side. And it's always hard to tell how far we actually are from the wall, so I'm going to use a lot of slow-mo here. Still a little bit away, so we look at the shadow, getting close, and then here comes the impact at really high speeds, flying through the air, and the whole bus is just going to crumble. Got to get the camera off, though, because it's starting to glitch out. And that is beautiful. And again, there's the ghost chair. I don't know what's up with the ghost chair. It's spooky, it's scary, just ignore it. So that was a pretty nice crash. Anyways, I think that's gonna do it for this video with my mini flying bus. Until next time, this has been YBR, and remember, if you like or dislike this video, I will know. I can tell by how well the bus flies. So do the right thing, and I'll see you next time.